So Alan Hershkowitz joins me now. Alan, you've just been sitting in on the last panel for discussion. Tell me what you made of the views that you heard, that you aired as well, and the platform that you shared.
Well, I think the overarching concern we have is sustainability. How do we preserve the planet for future generations? And we face the problem of increased population, increased consumption, with, frankly, environmentally ignorant technology.
You mentioned the issue of consumption within that. I mean, we have a billion in the world that are obese. We have a billion in the world that are hungry. This is one of the issues that you felt strongly about.
Yeah, we have squeezed out a lot of technological advances from our agricultural sector in the last 20 years. Great strides have been made, and yet we still have enormous problems. More and more land dedicated to livestock, more and more of the developing world committed to eating meat, more and more meat consumption in general, and meat consumption consumes more energy, more water, more arable land than any other type of food. We need an education program encouraging people to reduce their consumption of meat. We cannot handle the agricultural crisis that we face merely on the production side. With 9 billion people expected to be on the planet soon, 7 billion now, we need to change our consumption patterns so people eat healthier, and when they eat healthier, the agricultural sector benefits as well.
What are the solutions? I mean, where do we begin with these? Because one of the buzzwords today is innovation, but as the forum just now talked a little bit about, innovation is a word that's just kind of buzzed around a little bit. What kind of real meaningful dialogue can it have for you?
Innovation does not automatically mean ecologically better. It could mean ecologically risky. Biotechnology is innovation, without a doubt. But there's still a lot of uncertainties about it, and there's still a lot of absence of regulation. But it is a form of innovation. So really, what we need is innovation that is proven to be ecologically superior. And one of the innovations we need is to have a better dialogue about nutrition, because people are not eating healthy. And frankly, if they eat healthier, our agricultural system will improve and their personal health will improve. That will also help bring down medical costs. It will make people happier. They'll feel better about themselves. It will reduce our energy consumption. It will reduce our water use. Food is central to so many industrial sectors in terms of impacts.
So have you got the solution all wrapped up there in the one answer? It can't be quite as simple as that, can it?
Well, actually, affecting consumption is very, very difficult. It's wrapped up in socioeconomic, cultural issues. It's wrapped up in food prices. It's a very, very difficult thing to get to.
And views change all the time. I know certainly in the UK that only one in four people think really that there's any problem or suspicion about GM foods now.
Right. Well, you know, most people don't pay attention to science. In the United States, 13% of the population pays attention to science. 56% of the population pays attention to sports. So really, we don't have a very highly literate scientific population out there.
Finally then, you talked about the epicenter of food production will be the developing world. Yeah. You know, expand on that very briefly for me.
Well, within the next 5 years, by 2017, the majority of all agricultural crops, with the exception of some coarse grains and cheese, are going to be produced in the developing world. Now that is wonderful if it could raise the standard of living and increase the amount of arable land. But unfortunately, this is happening in many countries that have weak political infrastructure, weak administrative and regulatory oversight, no environmental laws. And remember, agriculture inherently uses water and pesticides and fertilizers and in some cases biotechnology. So there are many risks. And also traditional cultures become globalized. They become contracted out to transnational corporations and they lose their historic relevance.
Yes, you aired your views on Monsanto and Brazil, the example, quite vividly in the session. I'll let you go to lunch now, but just your view of this kind of forum, the views that are shared, the platform that people have here today. Very briefly, how important is that?
Well, I think it's wonderful that the forum allows me to speak in an agricultural setting where most of the speakers are from industry. I think it's good for the industry to hear competing views. Like I said, I didn't want to be the skunk at the picnic, and I didn't feel like the skunk at the picnic. I felt welcome, and I think people learn. You know, the best innovations happen from outside an industry.
Alan, thank you very much. Definitely not the skunk at the picnic. Enjoy the rest of today.
Thanks.